this is gonna be hot. And when it's hot, it's gonna...
Hello, my historical fashion friends. It is spring and I feel like a daffodil. Ugh, okay. Take that down. You see my face a little bit. Okay, today we are going to craft a Penannular Brooch, circa 1st century, Southeast Britain. Special thank you to Anna Booth, who wrote a 402-page thesis on Penannular Brooches, which I tried my best to understand with my layman's brain power. It was very detailed, and there's a lot of great diagrams. I printed out, actually, a couple of pages to guide me. It definitely helped to pinpoint the style for the time period and area which I was going for. So, thank you kindly for that expert work you did. Here we have our art clay, silver, and this is from Fire Mountain Gems and Beads. It's 20 grams, so I am very excited. Warning, this product is intended for adult fashion and decorative use only. Do not ingest. Adult fashion. Now, that can have many different meanings. Anyway, we are going to open this up and see what is inside. Aha! A packet within a packet. Yes. Here it is. This is our 20 grams, which is a very small amount. And here are the instructions, which are written in both English and not certain, but I believe this is Chinese. Yes. So, I will read the English instructions. Unfortunately, I don't read Chinese, but it would be really useful. Absolutely useful. Okay. Insufficiently dry clay may cause breakage during firing. Oxygen is consumed in smoke and or gas emission may result during firing. Be sure to ventilate the workroom well. Do not place recently fired clay on or nearby flammable objects as it may cause a fire. Very important. Take care not to get burned by the heat of clay when drying, firing, and or after firing. Absolutely, I could see myself definitely getting injured. Yes. Keep product out of the reach of children. Benston, Mogi, stay away. So, this is the design I am going for. It is a simple design. It is a classification of type C, as she listed, and it seems to be very prevalent around the area, which I am aiming for, sort of a little bit like the southeast of the UK region. This is based off of the area where King Cunobelinius, many different spellings of his name, would have been king in the early 1st century AD. This character, which I am making behind me for a scene which I am filming from Shakespeare's Cymbeline, but intended to be set during the late pre-Roman period, because there's definitely a lot of interaction between Rome and Britain at this time. And so there's sort of that influence of both types of clothing, Roman and the Briton style. So that's basically what I'm going for. And I've chosen this simple design, nothing too complicated for the first time. I am doing this and then firing it. I might just use a lighter. Oh no, only one battery? All right, well. I might just use a lighter. It says it needs to be like 1200 degrees, so I might do that, or set up like a series of candles to lighter it near. It has to be completely dry first, so I think basically it like air dries a little bit, and then it gets fired. And basically this clay, it has silver particles in it and then a binder which burns off. So after the binder burns off, you end up with a like 95% silver piece. So let us go to work on this. You can dry it with a hairdryer or a cooking plate. So yeah, you can dry it with a hairdryer for like 10 minutes to get it like dried. And then you can fire it in a kiln. But I'm gonna try to do it with just fire. So we'll see. I'm gonna charge this battery and just switch to this. So let's open this up. Wow. Okay. So yeah, so this is 20 grams and it is not a lot. So I'm basically gonna like pull off a piece for my little guy first, I guess. My little spike. And it does shrink, so I don't want it to like be too thin and small because it will really shrink. And that won't be super ideal. So I am going to basically like roll out a stick for the little stick part first. This is like super smooth feeling. I'm going to like make the loopy at the end, but then not fully connect it, so hopefully I can bend it a little bit after it dries. It says that after it dries, it should be basically like usable as a regular metal. So hopefully that means I can bend it some, or I'll have to get it hot again and then bend it. Trying to imagine what this will be like after it shrinks. Like, what is 8 to 9% shrinkage going to actually look like? I am not doing a good job of making this like roll super evenly. Getting a little cracky, so I just want to make sure that it doesn't really get like crappy. I feel like I'm doing this, but it's not getting any longer, but maybe I am mistaken. This is my first time like doing any sort of metalworky kind of thing. Let's see, yeah, that's going get too dry, little friend. I don't want you to get too dry. This is reminding me of like a tapeworm or something. See, it's like very dry down there. Right. But be smooth. Because I don't want it to, like, have all of these cracks and then, like, break when I'm firing it. Let's see, I can do this and then somehow like flip it over and then smooth out the other side. And then this is going to become our, like, rest of our brooch. So, let's roll out a long log and see how we can make the rest of our brooch. I'm just doing a very simple style. There's a lot of different styles. And there's a lot of highly decorated ones and less decorated ones, and also different regions have different types of decorations. I have a long snake. I'm gonna try to taper the ends, if I can, of our wee snake. And I have to be careful to, like, anticipate the shrinkage of this as well. And try to make our little loop-de-loops at the end. Well, let's go across. That just made me think of, does anyone remember Will It Blend? It was just like a thing on YouTube where someone had like a ninja blender or whatever, and they were always just like, will it blend?
Will it blend? That is the question.
And they blended like everything. Yeah, okay. That will go across this. If I can make it a little rounder. That's kind of cute, isn't it? I'm going to smooth it out. That's cute. Benston, you want to see what's going on? I'm making a penannular brooch. Gonna make it smooth. Maybe I'll flip it over and smooth out the other side. Oh, don't get stuck. Yes. Trying very hard to keep it like still circular. I also have to like keep in mind that this. The point of the brooch has to go through fabric, so maybe I should make it like a little skinnier. Yeah, it's gonna shrink 8 to 9%, so yeah, I think that's it. An A plus. Okay. That's a brooch, right? Do this like a little bendy. And hopefully that'll be the right size when it shrinks. Yes! I think I've done it. Okay. I think that like kind of looks like the thing. Right? Yeah? Okay. I guess like hair dryer. Because it's like hair dryer time. Right?
There's a big boy who eats out of a dish. There it is. Well, mommy, turn it for you. Yeah, that's yummy. That's so yummy. Yeah, this is delicious.
Let's see how it is.
Okay. I mean, for the video, could you use your other hand?
You're right. I am left-handed. I'm left-handed anyway. Well, I'm not supposed to stick it right into flame.
Yeah, like a Bunsen burner.
Oh my god. I just have to hold it like this for like half an hour.
Jerry rig some sort of string around the
mirror. I want the string catch on fire?
I mean, no, maybe. But I mean, there must be a way to hold it. Not if you wrapped a paperclip around that and then the string to the paperclip.
What about like a tin foil?
Tin foil will petrify it.
I don't know. What's the melting point of tin foil?
I don't know, but and I guess it won't. Like a hedgehog.
Yeah.
I don't know what it would be, but I would consider a different tactic, because that's going to take forever.
Y'all, this is taking so long. Also, I had a meltdown because I broke this. But I did not record that meltdown. It was not cute. But, okay, it's starting to get, like, a little metal-y. I don't know. Can you see? It takes a long time, though.
We're thinking of building some sort of campfire using my tiny cauldron and a pile of rocks, because I have a lot of rocks. I wish I had a gas stove. Okay, I can see metal. I can see metal. I don't know, we're thinking of either just getting more of this, like 10 grams, and making a new one of these, or just soldering it together. Because I obviously busted it. And then I tried to get it wet again, and it didn't go back together because it was mostly dried. Yeah. I was like, oh, maybe I didn't make the hole big enough. Let me just stretch it out like a dum-dum. As if I didn't learn from, like, the last 7 times that I was using clay. That you can't just, like, snap mostly bent clay and bend it. Because it's gonna be like that. Just gonna keep doing this. I'll show you if we build the campfire. I don't know. Going outside to find some rocks and sticks. Okay, like basically no rocks anywhere. Oh, I found rocks. Rocks. Oh yeah, give them a stone. What an epic fail. I just tried holding it over a candle for like ages, and then I tried to build a fire, and then for some reason it would not do fire in my little cauldron with newspaper, and it kept burning out really fast. I had to remove like 2 of my layers because it was really hot. Yeah, you'd think it wouldn't be hard to make a little campfire in Southern California and a little cauldron on your balcony, but apparently it is. So anyway, I didn't do anything to this piece because I'm just gonna pick up a butane torch on payday on Friday and try that. I'm definitely gonna have to redo the little stick part. I'm gonna look up what that's called because, yep, it's now in 4 pieces, so rest in pieces. Yikes. Apparently, I am just not meant to be friends with clay. Aiken. What a niche joke. What a niche early 2000s joke. Anyway, I'm going to see you all when I pick up a butane torch and also order more of this clay. Hello, my historical fashion friends! Continuing this episode at my friend Elise's apartment. You may remember Elise from the apron video.
I think it's pretty good. I think maybe the cabbage could cook a little longer.
Oh, when you made the campfire. So Elise has a gas stove and has kindly volunteered to allow me to use it since my stove is electric and it won't work for this. As you saw earlier, I tried to just hold it over a candle, which didn't work. And so we're gonna try using a stove. And I brought my my little pieces. Where'd they go?
Somewhere safe.
They're right here. We've got our little pieces here. We've got our Penannular Brooch 2 pieces, and I had a little extra, so I crafted a 6th century hair pin. We're gonna fire as well. So let's get started. Elise's sporting gorgeous Anglo-Saxon garb as well, but this is the Viking cap. So what can you do? We've only got so many items. She's looking very beautiful. Setting up the tripod. Ugh. Give a like if you want to see Elise in more videos. Okay,
We're gonna light this fire.
That's pretty hot.
Yeah, it should be. It said it should be red.
It looks pretty red to me.
I hope it
got red real fast.
Okay. I just like to burn myself like really horrifically. It's like put it where it's red. El Redo. It's supposed to be like 1500 degrees.
I have no concept of how hot my stove gets.
Oh my god, it's not there. Don't do it! Okay. Stop it. Okay. A little bit less hot. Gonna be a little bit low.
Keep that low.
You got a little excited, didn't you? Okay. Probably gonna be fine. It's supposed to do this. This is what it's supposed to do. Okay, I roll a low one dexterity.
So it's supposed to turn silver?
Yeah, it's gonna do the thing, and then when I like it's gonna polish up. Yep.
I'm hungry.
Yeah, looking at these snacks. These yummy brooch pieces. Fire is good. Bring you snacks, but I was afraid to mess up your diet.
I know. On the weekends, I kind of just do whatever I want. But
oh, sweet.
You know, too.
Yeah.
I'm gonna turn this off. Sorry for the sound.
Yeah, no worries. Should we open the thingy?
No, it's sucking it up. Yeah, I'm alright. I can open the door just in case.
What's happening? Basically nothing. Is it glowing? Is it glow?
I can't tell.
Is it glowing, McGee? Do we Give a little more glow. Give a little glow glow. Okay, I think this is that,
yeah.
That seems like it's glowing.
Yeah.
Glowing? Well, if I lift it up, I'll know. Oh, it is glowing.
Yeah?
It's glowing. Okay.
Oh, good.
Get yourself there. Get right on there and glow, you
glow.
Sweet little piece. Yeah, this is the con. Oh, you know what? It looks more like it's glowing on here. It looks like it's glowing.
I don't know
where. Oh, this one's glowing for now.
Oh! Oh, sweet diggity dog. Turn you over.
Sure.
Yeah, I think. It's been burning. It's been on fire. It's definitely been.
What is that?
Hmm.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Time to turn. All right, we're gonna turn it up. Let it cool down for 20 minutes. I think it worked, y'all. We're gonna see. I think it worked. I hope so. It's been on there for like 20 minutes.
It's,
so
yeah, it's smaller.
If it didn't, well, smaller. Verified.
It's smaller.
Verified. All right. Okay. Now we're gonna put them in the. Ooh. That sounded like metal, didn't it? I'm terrible at this.
Too excited.
You
know me? I'll do the last one.
Yeah.
I took off my guard.
Oops.
Yeah. Woo! Hey!
Oh, there it is.
All right.
How long do you leave it?
So we have already kind of filed this one, and you can see it becomes shiny. So, I'm just gonna do a little more filing here. I'm just using nail files because I don't really like have, I don't know, special files or whatever. It seems to be like working okay. So, I guess this is what we're gonna do for now. Because I guess when you fire it, it sort of crystallizes or something, it said. So you have to file it to get the silver to like polish and show. Not really sure about the exact science behind it, but it's all been filed on this one mostly. And it is looking quite shiny and I know these sound more metallic than this one, but this is just a fun one to do. That it's just supposed to be like a 6th century hairpin that I saw online, and I just thought it would be fun to kind of try and recreate it. So yeah.
looking pretty shiny. I think. So I'll try. This is one that was in my leather working toolkit, and I think it worked pretty good. You can just see, like, right away, it starts to become silvery. And I really hope that these are fired all the way through, because we left it on for a really long time. We weren't sure if we did it right, and it was kind of hard to tell. So something I already noticed that I did wrong about this was these are supposed to go like up, but I just looked at the side image and made it look like the side image and didn't realize until later that the front image basically had them just like as a loop that was up. So I'm not sure. I also thought this would shrink a lot more, and so I'm not really sure how it's going to work 100%. I'm also so nervous to bend this that I might actually decide to kind of add another piece on instead of try to bend this, because of the last time it made me like really nervous. Since I broke it. So I am just going to continue to polish these and basically just keep filing it until it's all shiny. And I will show you the finished product. Okay, so here we have them. I'm not sure how well this will work because it doesn't, clearly doesn't close all the way around it. And also it's very thick. I thought it was going to shrink a lot more, but it didn't shrink. I guess I don't really have a concept of even what 9% of this would have been, but yeah. And here's my little hairpin replica, and I'll put up a picture of the original, which I was trying to replicate. This is also a bit thick, but I'm happy for like a first try. I definitely want to try to use this material again and maybe make some that are a little thinner. And now knowing that I need kind of less, I think I can make more items from the amount of clay that I would get. But yeah, you can hear it's metal. It's making a metal noise. So it did fire, and it didn't break while I was shining it up, so I feel like it's fully fired properly. Yeah, so if you like this video, subscribe and let me know in the comments if you want to see more work with the art clay silver, and maybe I'll also try some of the bronze ones and the other types of metal clays as well. I am excited about this though, and I will see if it works on my costume when that's all finished. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time.
Who's that? Who's this little kitty? Is that Fenston?